Okay, this is like my fourth time trying to record this, so I'm gonna get it right this time, I swear. So I'm currently in the third week of basically a 3-week block where I'm in the field every single week doing different kind of training. The first week we did was platoon sticks. Sticks stands for something training gizzard size. And essentially it's just doing a lot of patrols, a lot of offensive operations like raids and ambushes and just general attacks that you would do. And that was by far the most physically intense week we've had here. You're basically getting maybe a couple hours of sleep a night and then just running missions the entire day with the leadership interchanging. With the whole idea of that being everyone gets a couple rounds being either the platoon leader or the platoon sergeant, and those give you chances where the instructors can evaluate you and see how you perform in those leadership roles. Everyone has to fill in the positions like squad leaders and team leaders, but they're not graded. But generally you want to be as good at those as possible because your performance can affect the grade of whoever's being graded for that particular section. Then last week what we did was urban operations or urban ops, which was definitely a change of pace and our normal long patrols in the woods and then doing one quick attack and then another really long foot march. The intensity of each mission was a lot higher than what we're used to, and that honestly made it just a lot more fun and a lot more engaging in each time. And also operating in an urban environment like that just changes the dynamic of everything completely and adds a huge layer of complexity that really makes the problem of an attack a lot more interesting. And then also at night when we were allowed to sleep in the buildings as opposed to the ground and the wind and the rain, that was nice. The only problem is the 75th Ranger Regiment was also kind of training in the same area as us, except they had live rounds. So there were a couple times where we were in the middle of something, we just kind of had to book it back to a safe location so they could do their thing. And then also at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, they would air assault in and then do a training like right next to us, which it's one of those weird military scenarios where if you were anyone else on the planet, that would be really, really cool to watch. But if you're trying to sleep at 2 or 3 in the morning and one building over where a bunch of Rangers are operating, it's not as cool. Not that I'm complaining. And then this week is defensive ops. So it's a lot more stationary than we're used to. Instead of going on to the attack as much, we'll be doing the defending and we'll be doing a lot of hole digging and barbed wire emplacement. So that'll be fun. But just so this video is not like a minute and 30 seconds long only with some highlight clips, I thought I'd talk about something that I've struggled with a little bit since I got here and something that I wasn't really expecting to be a speed bump. So I think something I wasn't really expecting is kind of the small personal sacrifices I've had to make towards the other parts of my life. And this is separate of like, you know, not being home with my family and wanting a little bit more free time to relax and stuff like that. That I'm not really concerned with. Everyone knows that's just part of the job is missing those two things. But something I wasn't really expecting once I graduated was that I have to put off a lot of my own personal goals to focus on what I'm doing right now. Because back at school, yeah, it was really intense and really busy hours and a heavy workload, but I was still able to focus on other personal goals like my writing and like my workouts and things of that nature that require a little bit of time and effort, but have a very intrinsic progress that goes along with them. And I thought that once I graduated that I'd have a little bit more time to put more towards them because I wasn't worried about school. My work didn't necessarily come home with me every night like it did at school. And my life would be a little bit more straightforward, which it is, but it's a lot more busy than I was expecting. In the sense that I don't have time to go to the gym nearly as much as I would like to, as opposed to the workouts that we do for PT in the mornings and occasionally in the field. And then other things that I enjoy doing, like putting more effort towards my writing or these videos, for example. They're things I've kind of had to put a little bit on the back burner so I can focus entirely on my training in IBOLC so that I can be successful, in the months and years to come. And I think the mental struggle of trying to balance all of my own personal goals as well as what was going on in the military, because like I've said before, this channel isn't necessarily a military channel. I like to think of it more as stuff that I'm doing and that's going on in my life, but at this very moment, I happen to be in the military doing training, and I'm happy to share that with everyone and answer questions about it. However, I do like having other things that are going on in my life that I'm working towards, and things that just give me a sense of accomplishment and fulfillment that I enjoy doing. And I think I made IBOLC a lot harder, especially in the first half, by just trying to mentally fight and find a weird balance in between all the things I'm pursuing. Instead of what I've realized recently and something I need to focus better on is that I just need to focus on one thing at a time, and that those other personal goals of mine are still there. They're still equally as important and I still get just as much fulfillment out of them. However, they kind of need to take a break because it's starting to affect my mental capacity while I'm doing training in IBOLC. Because, for example, if I try to put just as much effort into my training as I do my riding or my lifting or other things that don't push me forward in my training, but the things that I get a sense of fulfillment out of, everything suffers. So not only am I doing worse in my training, I'm also not riding as well, my videos aren't as good, and my fitness suffers. But recently, Okay, my camera is really starting to mess up with me. This is probably the fifth time I've been trying to record this now. Long story short, I know I got that last bit. So just to summarize everything, once you get here, just focus entirely on IBOLC. Kind of embrace that this is gonna be your life for a good bit and that you'll kind of, I guess, regain your personality and your life once you're finished with it. That was like something very shockingly fatalistic for me to say, but it's the quickest way I can put it up before my camera dies again.